Hornet 2 GEF-404 turbofan engines spooling up to their maximum power, producing over 36,000 pounds of thrust. Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you your United States Navy's FA-18 Hornet.
Thank you.
Approaching at 175 miles per hour, the pilot flies a descending turn to a three-quarter mile final approach point. The speed only allows about 15 seconds to precisely adjust his flight path in order to touch down in an area not much larger than your driveway. Notice as the Hornet approaches from the light left, I can see the light. The gear will be down and the tail will be extended. It is this tail hook that allows the FAAC to land and stop at under 400 feet. The gear is down and the hook is down as well.
Thank you.
do is approach at that 140 knot or 170 mile an hour, approximately 160 to 70 mile an hour approach speed. He will not have the tail hooked down at this point, but he will demonstrate what it's like to approach the deck of a carrier. He will be in a descent rate of some 700 to 1,000 feet per minute. It is a very, very hard landing. But just in case, on an actual carrier, the tail hook does not catch one of the four wires stretched across the deck, the pilot, the minute he feels his aircraft touch down, will shove the throttles forward, just in case, because he'll need that power to go around. Let's fade the music, guys. Let's listen to these power changes.
Naval Air Station Oceana Airshow. Y'all have a
time so far was actually a loser in a competition with the Air Force for a lightweight fighter. The aircraft that won the competition was the F-16 Fighting Falcon, but the team went back to Northrop.
F-18 clearing up the southwest.